yeah, the future is full of uncertainties. And it's really hard to know what you can be certain of. I think most of it is just hopes. It's really uncertain. But I am actually certain that I will just pursue my dream as being a filmmaker. I'm certain that I'm going to do this because I've done this my entire life.
And I chose to be a creative person and what I wanted to expect from the path. I think it started all in my childhood, and my parents were a big influence to that. My father was the biggest role for that. He didn't push me too much, but he gave me the space for creativity. It started when I was in fourth grade that I played music, and I started to play in a jazz band, saxophone, with my teacher. And for me, this was the start of my creativity.
A difficult time in my life, skating home from school, and I was on a boosted board, which is like an electric skateboard. And I'm going down a hill way too fast, and I'm not paying attention. So I hit a pothole, and I face plant in the cement, and I break my nose. It sort of, you know, it puts you in a bad mood. You're like, I've wasted this semester. Like, I haven't really met anyone.
I would tell my younger self, you may feel like that you already know enough about the world and people, but you don't. You're always going to be learning new stuff about your life, about other people.
That's life. Sometimes you smash your face in cement, and you gotta fix it.
What our future is holding, I think it's true that the future is full of uncertainties. Like, nobody ever expected to be in a pandemic in 2020, I guess. I know what my future is holding. I choose my future like completely dreaming, seen by somebody bigger, more serious, and actually earning money with writing scripts one day.
The most difficult time in my life would have to be when I was born. I was born premature, and I had to stay in the hospital for 3 months. And I was pinned up to all these machines. It, in a way, shaped the person I am.
I used to study IT, then I went to university, and within 2 weeks I gave up. I just knew it wasn't for me. Moved away from my family, my parents got divorced, lost all my friends because we were shattered across the country. All of a sudden, walked by my favorite book, I remembered that there was a film, and I loved that book so much that I said, you know, why not just give it a try? From that moment on, I knew I wanted to make films.
The future is full of uncertainties. I don't know if I am sure that my future is going to hold something.
This one moment in the middle of nowhere, how to get home, and there wasn't the path. It was just grass, sheep, and some trees. And the decision I had to make is, do I go a little bit further on the right side? Then I just drop like 100 meters down. Or if I just try to go forward and then might go past my home. And at some point, I didn't expect it, but I saw a light, and this was my hostel, and I survived.
If I go back in time right now, and they tell myself in Syria in 2010 that I'm going to be in Germany studying something that I've never thought of, well, I wouldn't believe that. So I don't know where I'm going to be, like, let's say 10 years, 20 years from here, or like 50 years. The point is, this is what makes it beautiful. We can work hard on something.
I put a lot of things off in life because of fear. I think I always had a lot of passion and drive, but if I wasn't already great at it, I didn't want to do it. And I think that if I could really emphasize anything, it would really be to walk through fear, take things head on, and believe in myself.
I think when I see myself in this path, I say, be fortunate that you have this, making sure you use your resources for the good of mankind or whatever.
I think it can always be better, but I'm doing something that I love. And if I ask myself, would I want to be there or here? I would 100% choose to be here.
I guess my future will hold a lot of fun still, because I got some cool friends and some cool companies while I'm firefighting all time. And that will be always part of my life, I guess. So there's one thing that I will never miss or will never leave. I'm not sure if the future is always a great time. Sometimes you have to do things that you don't like that much to get the things that you like.
I wanted to create something in which people could see into other worlds and that's not like theirs and use their imagination. Those are the movies that I enjoy the most. It's not real ones that are grounded in reality.
So also, if I look at Corona, I'm not sure if I will come to US in the next year, and we will see if it happens or not. Yeah. Also because of Corona, the future is always changing. Like, I was dreaming about getting a job that will never be unsafe, for example, at events or parties.
I think the most difficult time in my life was when I was in job training to be an event technician. I started working in this field during school, and then I started my training in a big company and they treated me like shit. But I had this big goal in my mind that I wanted to like to go this route.
If I could tell my younger self what to expect, I would ask them to not have as much expectations as you had. Because when I moved to America, I thought everything was gonna like blow up. It's so cliche that the grass is always greener on the other side, but I really needed to learn that it really isn't.
The thing they told us was just, you're not good enough. You're not trying to be part of the team. And it took me a very long time to realize that this is not the environment to be like growing up in. It took me, I think, almost 2 years to realize that I could just quit and go study in Hamburg and do what I want.
I needed to learn how to like, even if it wasn't as crazy as I thought it was going to be, it's still going to be great if I make it great.
We'll be right back.